friends, today we have to start here question number 9 from practice set 2.3. I had already uploaded the video up to question number 8, okay? So we will start here. Question number 9, that is rationalize the denominator, okay? We have to rationalize only the denominator part. So how to solve this type of the questions? So what is the first question? That is 3 upon root 5, okay? What is the, which value indicates the denominator? That is root 5. Root 5 is the denominator and 3 is the numerator. So we have to rationalize this root 5. So how to solve this? So for rationalizing the denominator, we have to multiply numerator and denominator by this number. Okay, that is root 5. So write down the first given, that is 3 upon root 5. Then next write down multiply root 5, multiply root 5 on numerator and denominator. Multiply this root 5 on numerator and denominator. Then what we have to get here? That is 3 root 5 write down, and in multiplication write down the root 5 into root 5. Okay, what we have to do here? We have to multiply this root 5 on numerator as well as the denominator. Then what we have to get here? That is 3 root 5, and this root 5 and root 5 gets 5 into 5. That means what you have to get here? 3 root 5 upon root 25. So 3 root 5 upon root 25. So what is the value of root 25 here? That is 5 itself. 3 root 5 upon 5. So therefore, what is the answer? I have to write here. Therefore, after the rationalizing the denominator, what you have to get? 3 root 5 is equal to 3 root 5 upon 5 after rationalizing the denominator. And this is your final answer of your first number question. Yeah. Now next, second one, that is 1 root 14. 1 upon root 14. Second, 1 upon root 14. So, what, which value indicates the denominator? That is root 14. So, same steps apply. Write down the first given part, 1 upon root 14. Then, next we have to write down multiply numerator and denominator by what? Multiply numerator and denominator by root 14. Okay, root 14. Then what we have to get? We have to get 1 into root 14 upon root 14 into root 14. Okay, wait. 1 root 14 is root 14 itself and divided by root 14 into root 14. You have to solve by using these steps, or directly you have to write down the 14 only, because root 14 into root 14 is equal to 14. Like root 5, in previous example, root 5 into root 5, what you have to get finally? That is 5. If you want to write all these steps, otherwise you have to write down directly. Okay, so what we have to get? Second number question, that is therefore after rationalizing the denominator, 1 upon root 14, what? 1 upon root 14 is equal to root 14 upon 14, and this is your final answer of your question number 2. Now If you want to write this, take this screenshot of it. Now you have to solve the third number question. Third, 5 root 7, and you have to rationalize denominator. You have to rationalize denominator. Then what is the value in denominator? That is root 7. So write down the given part as it is, and then write down the statement: multiply numerator and denominator by root 7. Sorry, 7. Root 7. Okay? So, what will we get? That is 5 into root 7 upon root 7 into root 7. 5 into root 7? 5 root 7. And 7, root 7 into root 7? That is why we have write down 7. Okay? Then what you have to get? Therefore, 5 root 7 is equal to 5 upon root 7 is equal to 5 root 7 upon 7. And this is the final answer of the question number 3. Yeah? Now, next question we have to solve, that is question number 4. That is 6 upon 9 root 3. 6 upon 9 root 3. Okay, 6 upon 9 root 3. So, write down the given number, that is 6 upon 9 root 3. So, for this one, which value of the denominator is the square root? That is only 3. So, multiply numerator and denominator by what? By root 3 only. Okay, so multiply numerator and denominator by root 3. Only root 3, okay? So what we have to get? 6 into root 3 upon 9 root 3 into root 3. Then 6 into root 3, that is 6 root 3. 9 in root 3 into root 3, that is 9 into 3. Understand this one? Okay? Now next. What we have to do here? 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. That means what is the new number? That is 2 root 3 upon 9. Okay? Therefore, what we have to get? 6 What we have to get? 6, 9 upon root 3 is equal to 2 root 3 upon 9. Okay? And this is the final answer of the question number 4. Yeah? Now, next one, that is 5th number question, and it is the last question from this one, that is 11 upon root 3. 11 upon root 3. So, what is given here? What is given? That is 11 upon root 3. So, write down given part as it is 11 upon root 3. So, which number multiply numerator and denominator? Only root 3. Okay. So, write down multiply numerator and denominator by root 3. Okay? You have to multiply numerator and denominator by what? Root 3. So, what we have to get? 11 into root 3 upon root 3 into root 3. So, 11 into root 3, that is 11 root 3. Root 3 into root 3, that is what we have to write down here. So, what we have to write? What we have to get here? That is, therefore, 11 upon root 3 is answer of your question number 5. Clear? So, in this way, you have to complete your question number 9. Clear? So, I hope you have to understand this practice set, because in this practice set there are 9 questions. So, for each and every question I will prepare, I had already uploaded the videos on that. Okay? So, I hope you have to understand this practice set. Okay? This is your last question, that is question number 9 from this practice set. So, we will stop here. I hope you have to understand from this video. So, please like it, subscribe it, and share it with your friends. Thank you, students.